Alright, and when I was a kid, there was nothing like a good old-fashioned school fundraiser. I don't know if things have changed these days, but back in my day, they would just herd all of us kids into the auditorium, and we'd be sitting there totally clueless. What the hell's going on? Is it the Russians? Are the Russians attacking? Alright, class, today we're gonna have a guest speaker here to talk to you about a school fundraiser. Now, these guest speakers had one goal in mind, and that was to get all of us kids as hyped as possible so we'd go out and sell as much shit as possible. And for the most part, it'd work. There'd be this dude up there with a boombox, all amped up like he just did a couple of Ripper Magoos in the bathroom. You guys ready to sell some candy bars? Yeah! Y'all ready to get exploited for some cash? Hell yeah! And of course, a school fundraiser is nothing without all the shitty prizes that you could win. The more candy bars you sell, the more bullshit that you receive. That's right, if you sell over 700 candy bars, you'll win this sweet, sweet Tony Danza slap bracelet. Oh yeah, I don't know who the fuck Tony Danza is, but I gotta have that slap bracelet. And then there'd always be like the most ridiculous grand prize for whoever sold the most candy bars. And whoever sells the most candy bars, they will get the super duper grand prize, the state of New Mexico. So we get out of school for the day, and we're all amped up with our little stupid suitcases filled with candy bars. Nobody's gonna outsell me! That state of New Mexico is as good as mine! You get home and you immediately corner your parents. Hey, Dad, how about you go ahead and buy yourself some of these here candy bars? How about you go ahead and go fuck yourself instead? How about that? You need to get your ass out there and go door to door and put your life on the line like all the other kids. So me and my dumbass friends venture out into our neighborhood, try to sell as many candy bars as possible. The only problem was that these candy bars were generic as hell. I mean, it just said candy bar in the wrapper. And shit. They're super bland. They taste like a goddamn alarm clock. Who the hell's gonna buy these things?
Hey, you wanna buy some candy bars for our school fundraiser?
Kid, I've eaten assholes that taste better than those goddamn candy bars. No thanks.
Candy bars for sale. Would you like to buy one?
Hey, honey, you wanna buy some bullshit from these dirty little kids?
No.
Nope, not interested. Hello, sir. Would you like to buy a candy bar for a good cause? I got the type 2 diabetes, you little shit. You trying to kill me? You can shove those candy bars up your little third grade asses. Alright, so clearly this was gonna be a lot harder than we initially thought. So what do we decide to do? Well, we decide to start lying to people. You know, try to guilt them into buying these goddamn candy bars.
Hi, my dog has rickets, and we're selling candy bars to help raise money for him. Oh my god, your dog has rickets? How awful. Honey, go get your checkbook. This dirty little boy's dog has rickets.
And being the dumbass little kids that we were, we'd go to every house on the block. We didn't care who it was. I think we should skip this house. It says no soliciting right there.
Oh no, they're talking about hookers. My stepdad says that's what soliciting means.
Hey, assholes! The sign says no solicitors!
Is he calling us hookers? Hey, you dirty old man, I'm not a hooker! I'm trying to raise money for the penguins in Puerto Rico!
The penguins in Puerto Rico? Oh, well, hell, you should have said that to begin with! Let me find my checkbook! Hell, we'd be so desperate to make a sale, we'd even go to the creepy old guy's house on the end of the block. Yeah, I don't know about this. My dad said this guy's not allowed to go within 300 yards of a Chuck E. Cheese.
Oh, to hell with that! I need to get that Tony Danza slap bracelet!
Yeah, what do you kids want?
Hi, I'm raising money for my stepdad's hysterectomy. Can you buy a candy bar?
I'll buy whatever you want me to if you come inside and play hide the banana.
No thank you. I'm not soliciting right now.
You guys wanna come inside and eat Hot Pockets and watch me clip my toenails? Alright, let's get the fuck out of here.
Hey, where are you guys going? You guys should come in my backyard and see if you can fit in this hole that I just dug.
So after a few weeks selling these crappy candy bars, we finally get our shitty prizes that we worked so hard for. Wow, that was totally not worth it. Yeah, and I still don't know who the fuck Tony Danza is. But the worst part of it all had to be that the kid that sold the most candy bars in my class didn't do a goddamn thing. He didn't scour his neighborhood and dodge pedophiles left and right. No, he just had his parents take his candy bars to their work, and they sold them all for him. So we busted our ass for these stupid Tony Danza slap bracelets, and this asshole wins the state of New Mexico. God damn it.
Brewstew.com.